Hello everyone, in this video, we are going to see a deadlock using a very simple SQL query and by opening two simple terminals, and we are going to visualize how the database deadlock look like. Now, once you are able to visualize how the database deadlock look like and how does it occur, you will be able to avoid deadlocks in your production system. So let's quickly get started. The first thing is, let's understand what exactly deadlock is. Now, if you have a database with you, any database, SQL database, Postgres database, etc. What exactly deadlock means? Now, the thing is, if you have a database, you would be having lots of transactions running on your database. All the calls which are coming to your backend system might be making call to the database, and you might be having some sort of transaction. Now, when you have transactions, which it means that you might be taking a lock on a particular table or a row based on the use case. Now, a deadlock can occur when a transaction 1 is waiting for a resource which is occupied by transaction 2, and transaction 2 is waiting for the resource which is occupied by transaction 1. And in that case, when this circle is found, the deadlock is, that condition is called as deadlock. And many times, database is able to detect this particular circle and it fails the last transaction which caused the deadlock. So in this case, let's say a transaction 1 is waiting for a resource which is occupied by transaction 2. The moment transaction 2 tries to wait for a resource which is occupied by transaction 1, then a deadlock will be detected and then the transaction 2 will end up in a failed state. So that's what exactly the deadlock is. Now let's see how a deadlock can occur and how do we avoid it. So first we'll see a simple deadlock situation in a Postgres database so that we can understand how things are going on. So let's say you have two transactions. I'll open the terminal as well and show you, but just to give a picture. So I have two transactions running side by side, and let's say I take a row lock on a particular table by running some update command, and then I take a row lock on that same table, basically on a row, by running some other command. So we both the transaction waiting for some resource, and then I try to take the lock on the first record, and the moment I try to take the lock on the second one, there will be deadlock. Now the things might be a little confusing, so what I'll do is that I'll open the terminal and show you the same thing. So here I have a Postgres terminal with me, and I have my database installed, etc. You can install Postgres database by yourself. It's not very hard. So here I have some table with me. So I'll run command select star from bank balance. So I have a database with me, and let's run the command select star from bank balance. You see there are two people, Anubhav and Arjun. They both have some money in their account. And now we want to create the scenario of deadlock. So let's begin the transaction. We begin the transaction with begin command. Okay, let's roll back. Maybe there is old transaction running. So we have a transaction started in both the terminals. Now I'll update bank balance. Set bank balance, balance equal to balance plus 5, where ID is equal to 1. So basically I am increasing the balance by 5 rupees for ID is equal to 1. So right now if you see select star from bank balance, you can see there are two people and the balance for Anubhav became 208. Now in the second transaction, let's increase the value of Arjun by 5 rupees or let's decrease it, doesn't really matter. So let's update bank balance, set balance equal to balance minus 5, where ID is equal to 2. So 5 rupees might have got detected for ID is equal to 2. Now if we run select statement in the second terminal, so we would see that the 5 rupees are deducted from Arjun's account. So since the left transaction is not yet committed, 285 value is not yet here. Now on the right left side again, let's try to take lock on the bank balance equal to 5, because I mean the ID is equal to 5, that's the Arjun's account. So right till now what has happened is that the left one has taken the lock on Anubhav and write transaction has taken lock on Arjun. Now let's try to take lock on Arjun from the left side. So let's say I run command update bank balance set anything, it doesn't really matter, where ID is equal to 2. So basically I'm trying to take lock on Arjun on the left side, which has already been taken on the transaction in the right side. So if I do that, you see left one is in a waiting state. It is not able to execute. So it's in a waiting state that, hey, the moment this transaction completes, I'll proceed with my own thing. Now, on the transaction on the right side, if it tries to take lock on Anubhav, basically on ID is equal to 1, let's see what happens. So select update, let's update it. Update bank balance set balance equal to balance T. Doesn't really matter. Basically, the intent is to take a lock on the row where ID is equal to 1. So take a pause of 2-3 seconds and try to guess what will happen. So till now, if you see, the left one has taken lock on Anubhav, the right one has taken lock on Arjun, the left one is waiting for right one to release the lock on Arjun, and now the right one is trying to take lock on Anubhav. So right one is trying to create a circle. So let's see what happens here. And you see the deadlock got detected and this particular transaction failed. The deadlock detected, process waits for a share lock blocked by other process, and that's why the database was able to detect the deadlock. The left one succeeded and the right one actually did not succeed. So it actually failed, the right one. So the last transaction which completed the circle was detected by the database and then it failed. Now this particular approach is not good for the database because they have to do a lot of work to detect these cycles and then kill the transaction, and then you might also have to retry the transaction, and sometimes that might not be even good. So how do we avoid the database transactions? So there are two approaches with which you can avoid the database transaction, and we'll discuss both of them one by one. The first is that whenever you update the bank balance or whenever you update the rows or tables of particular IDs, try to update in the same order. So if you update in the same order, then you will not end up in the deadlocks. So let's see how exactly it is happening. So let's roll back both the transaction on the left side and the right side. Left side was anyway succeeded. So let's try to update the bank balance in the same order. So let's begin the transaction, or let's say roll back, because we didn't commit the earlier. So let's begin the transaction on the left side. Let's begin the transaction on the right side. Let's do update bank balance set balance equal to balance plus 5 where ID is equal to 1. So the idea is that left one needs to update the bank balance of 1, balance 1 and balance 2. The account 1 and account 2, and the right one also needs to do in the same order. So we updated the balance. Now on the right side, instead of updating the bank balance that ID is equal to 2, we'll update the bank balance of the first one itself. So update bank balance set balance equal to balance minus 5 where ID is equal to 1. So you can sort by ID, or you can figure out a way in which the order is always the same in both the sides. Now you see the right one would be stuck. The right one will be stuck till the time unless I, commit the transaction. So let's say I run one more command, bank balance set balance equal to balance minus 5 where ID is equal to 2. And then the moment I commit it, then only the transaction on the right side would be able to proceed. So in this way, if you update the things in the same order, so you will try to take the lock on the rows in the same order, and in that way you can avoid the database transaction. That's one approach. There is one more approach, and let's talk about that too. So the second approach is basically a sort of pessimistic locking, where you take the lock on all the rows before you try to update the rows. So let's see what exactly I'm trying to say here. So let's roll back the one on the right side and let's begin the transaction. So what exactly I'm trying to say? Let's begin the transaction on the left side. Let's begin the transaction on the right side. Now I want to update ID is equal to 1 and ID is equal to 2. Basically, if we do select star from bank balance, so I want to update both the accounts. So there is a way to do that. Select star from bank balance where ID is equal to 1 or ID is equal to 2 for update. Now here when I write this keyword for update, it takes up the lock on both the rows. Now on the left, on the right side, let's say I write the same thing. Select star from bank balance where ID is equal to 1 or ID is equal to 2 for update. Let's say I try to write this. You see the one on the right side would be stuck. So you can pre-compute what are the rows which you want to update and you take the lock on all the rows. Now you can update things on the left side, basically update bank balance, set balance equal to balance plus 50 where ID is equal to 1. You can do this. Then you can also write update the same thing, update bank balance, set balance is equal to balance minus 50 where ID is equal to 2. And then you can commit the transaction. The moment you committed, the thing on the right side can proceed. So in this way, if you take the needed logs on all the rows which you wish to update, and then you proceed, in that way also you would be able to avoid the database transaction. So yeah, that was my idea overall. And that's what I wanted to communicate, that how you can avoid the database transaction. I hope you were able to visualize as well. So if you open two different terminals, you can actually visualize the database transactions. And once you are able to visualize the database transaction, it will be easy for you to avoid them as well. Now, this video is not, I would not say, it does not cover the complete depth of the database transaction. I might make a video or a series on database deadlocks and transactions, but I hope this would have given you an intro to how things work and how the deadlock can occur. Just of it. So yeah, that's it from my side for this topic. Till the next time, bye.